On September 12th, 2023, the world was made aware of an allegedly unknown inhuman species.
What?
Crazy, I know. Let's back up a bit because I just dropped a huge bomb on you and I think starting at the beginning is the easiest way to explain it. Hi, I'm V. Welcome to Life's Biggest Questions. Buckle in because today I'll be rambling through my thoughts on the hearing that took place in Mexico. Humans have been worried about alien invasions for hundreds of years. There are mentions of UAP sightings spanning all the way back to ancient civilizations. The fear that a more advanced civilization capable of destroying our world is lurking just out of sight has paved the way for hundreds of conspiracies and theories to form over the years. But what if they're not just theories anymore? What if we now had physical proof that a smarter, more advanced species existed, and not only existed, was here, on Earth with us? Well, the shocking thing is, these may not be what-if questions anymore. This year, being the first year that has held official government hearings surrounding UAP, has drawn out a lot of wild claims. In the US, military personnel have reported that the US government is in possession of inhuman biologics and UAP. One man stated the things he had seen surrounding inhuman biologics and injuries caused by inhumans were extremely disturbing. He said, quote, "I have to be very careful here. What I personally witnessed, myself and my wife, was very disturbing," end quote. Jaime Musan, a journalist, researcher, and self-proclaimed ufologist, took the stand at a UAP hearing in Mexico, presenting two cases containing inhuman life. The following information is all alleged, as it's based on recounts of witnesses, translations, and personal research. In 2015, Jaime found his first inhuman specimen. In 2017, two bodies were recovered from deep underground in the sandy Peruvian coastal desert of Nazca, Peru, found wrapped in algae. Jaime said that the location they were found in was clearly deliberate, as it assisted with the conservation and preservation of the creatures' bodies. The area is also well known for having giant figures carved into the earth that are only visible from a bird's eye view. The lines are mainly attributed to indigenous communities, but they have influenced people to create a vast collection of theories about the area. Jaime somehow came into the possession of the bodies and began to study them. He described them as, quote, "bodies approximately 60 centimeters long, covered by a white powder that, through electron microscopy, we identify as diatom powder, which allows the desiccation of the bodies as well as the absence of the generation of bacteria, fungi, and cadaveric fauna. The presence of this dust allows the perfect conservation by desiccation of these bodies, causing a natural conservation process over time, which we were able to calculate by applying the carbon-14 test, which indicated and dated an average of 1,000 years old." Jaime claims to have conducted a plethora of tests which covered essentially every part of the body. He did x-rays, 3D reconstructions, comparative analysis, and DNA analysis. He conducted a computed tomography, or CT scan, which is an x-ray imaging procedure which creates images of slices, kinda, which can then be studied. He ran histology tests, which allowed for the visualization of tissue structure and characteristic changes the tissue may have undergone. It's a microscopic study of tissues and organs through sectioning and staining. He also claims the specimens underwent studies of forensic anthropology, which is a subfield of the studying of human remains. The tests were apparently very telling. They not only confirmed that the creatures were not human, but they also provided researchers insight into the creature's biology and build. He also mentioned that the creatures had three fingers and toes, two legs, two arms, a head, an abdomen, and a neck. To state the obvious, that's a very humanoid structure. Forensic anthropology and 3D reconstructions revealed the bone structure of the creature had, quote, "perfect harmony and agreement between the joints," end quote. Jaime also mentioned that they had observed the wear of the bones, focusing on the biomechanics of the creature. They had resistant bones, extremely light but very strong. He compared them to the bones of a bird. Their necks were a long structure that joined to the head in the middle floor of the skull. That connection point does not occur in primate species. Like, it's never been recorded. Primates have a circular space where our spinal cord connects to our brain, but Jaime said that these creatures had a rectangular-shaped hole. They have a large pneumatized skull, which means it has holes in it. The spaces allow it to be very light while still being rigid and protective. It has a large inner cavity, which told researchers that the creature's brain would have been very large. The eye cavities were also so large, which would have allowed for amazing stereoscopic vision. Stereoscopic vision allows enhanced depth and peripheral vision. It had very small nostrils, and its jaw joint and lack of teeth allowed researchers to determine that the creature mainly swallowed its nutrition, opposed to chewing it. They found that their necks were retractable, much like a turtle. They found that the thorax had a bone, very similar to birds, which would have provided increased mobility in their shoulders and arms. They did not have carpal or tarsal bones, so they wouldn't have wrist or ankle mobility. Their ribs were completely circular and connected to the vertebral column. There was a very small space between them, and they had 14 to 16 ribs. The bodies were also, okay, wait, 14 to 16? How do you not know whether it's 14 or 16? Like, wait, scroll. How do you not know whether it's 14 or 16? Like, this man is coming out with all of these tests, doing all of this insane research, and the one thing that he could actually physically see on the x-rays, bones, ribs, he couldn't decide whether there were 14 or 16? Simple, is it 8 or 7 on each side? He was out here acting like a genius, like, they had large cavities and such, and stereoscopic, and you're telling me the thing that stumped him was the number of ribs. Like, at that point, just lie. Just lie and say 15. I don't care if that wouldn't make sense. So you're not filling in the age range section of an online survey. Just say a singular number. Just, okay. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't, whatever. I'm done. Okay. The bodies were also found with metal discs under their skin. The discs were a metallic alloy, which included both osmium and cadmium. These two metals stood out to researchers because both are currently used for satellite telecommunications. That's pretty alien if you ask me. Thanks to the tomology, DNA analysis, comparative analysis, and a carbon-14 test, some extremely interesting biological revelations were made, and they were able to find out the approximate age of the beings. They found that the creatures were about 1,000 years old. They were able to see traces of muscles, tendons, ligaments, and blood vessels, as well as possible organs or organelles. At a millimetric level, they were able to find oviducts, which had the presence of eggs, which told Jaime that the creatures had a continuous gestation process, like humans and most mammals. Looking at you, platypus. Because of all these tests, they were able to confirm that the creatures were 100% organic and biological. Not falsified, as the replication of the developing eggs in the oviduct would be impossible. They even found fingerprints on the creatures, but of course, they're not just normal fingerprints, nuh-uh. Unlike us who have circular fingerprints, they have lines. Yes, lines, horizontal lines more specifically. But the most amazing claim that was made by Jaime were the claims surrounding the DNA analysis of the species. Jaime claimed that they sent the DNA out to labs not only nationally, but internationally. That's right. Though he didn't say what labs or countries they were sent to, he did give us the important information that it was in fact sent out both nationally and, more impressively, internationally. The labs compared the samples with over 1 million registered species, and the results gave evidence that only 70% of the genetic material coincides with what is known. For some perspective, the difference in DNA between us and a dog is less than 16%. The difference between us and some bacteria is less than 15%. A difference of 30 is like comparing us to a slug or a banana almost. The difference is unprecedented and totally outside the parameter of what is expected. Jaime closed his presentation by saying, "I can affirm then that these bodies are 100% real, organic, and biological. That at a time they had life and are irrefutable evidence in themselves. We are facing the paradigm of describing a new species or the opportunity to accept that there has been contact with other non-human beings that were drawn and pointed out in the past, in various cultures throughout the world, such as Peru, Egypt, and Mexico, and that today we can accept their existence among and with us. Thank you very much." Okay, so the research that Jaime spoke about is absolutely incredible. The only thing that would be even more incredible is if he actually had proof of the research. Jaime did not present a single piece of evidence supporting his claims. He just spoke about a lot of tests, observations, and discoveries. And I'm not necessarily dismissing Jaime's claims or saying they're definitely untrue. I'm just saying that a lot more information needs to be provided, like documents, test results, video proof, cross-checking, collaborating. Until then, I'm not inclined to fully believe his claims, especially because, and here's a shocking plot twist for you guys. Do you remember how at the very beginning of this video, I mentioned Jaime had collected his first claimed non-human specimen in 2015? Yeah? Good. You were listening. Well, he was lying. It was not inhuman, and he was aware that it was not inhuman, as he had fabricated it. He lied. So yeah, he has a messy track record, a lack of proof, and a strange aversion to choosing between 14 and 16. Yeah, I'm back on that because it doesn't make any sense. It's like asking him, oh, how many specimens have you found? And he says, 1 to 2. Like, no, it's just 1 or 2. You can visually see that it's 1 or 2. In the photos, you can literally see the ribs poking out. How are you gonna say 14 to 16 ribs? How do you not know? Interestingly, the US has actually created an organization dedicated to identifying and researching aerial phenomena called the ARO, or the All Domain Anomaly Resolution Office. This program is actually directed by an accomplished physicist named Dr. Sean Kirkpatrick, which, as a person who enjoys skeptical sciences, having an accomplished, credible scientist in charge of this program really excites me. Kirkpatrick is dedicated to following science and to providing the public with any information that is found. Too often, people discredit UFO conspiracists, but really, the thought that there's other species in this universe isn't outlandish. In fact, it's extremely rational. I mean, yes, there is a line, but for the most part, people are just participating in scientific theorizing. Science is about asking questions, making up theories, disproving theories, making mistakes, finding answers, understanding, learning. Curious, skeptical, bizarre minds do make the best scientists. So that brings us to the conclusion of the video. I would love to hear your opinions on Jaime and any other UAP-focused hearings that have occurred over the past year. I want to make it clear that whether the creatures are real or not, it doesn't confirm or deny any other theories or questions that we've had over the years. There will always be something new for us to theorize about, but it would be pretty flippin' awesome if Jaime could get in that research and prove them to be real. Scary, but awesome. Thank you so much for joining me today as I dove into the Mexico UAP hearing. I hope you enjoyed the video, but more importantly, I hope you learned something new. See you around, and remember to stay curious.